Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Half-Life 2, our second stop on the road to Half-Life 3. Oh my god, this boat is so much faster than I remember it being. We're gonna fly through the- Oh! Do not hit the tree stumps. That is not a good idea. Do some sick tricks. Some sick ollies. There we go, let's not spend too much time in the water. All we need to do is come up here, open the gate. Just turn it as slowly as possible. There we go. And now that it's stuck there, we can dip our toe into the water and then get back on the river. Old Man River. Something, I don't know, more words. Water hazard. This is actually probably my least favorite section of the game. There's a cache here. Let's come up here and grab it. So we can get credit for our lambda progress. Not sure if we'll actually get much lambda progress. We could just totally skip this. Oh, you know, I should have taken a look up there on our way up here, because G-Man does hang out on the bridge up there. I think this is the one. He hangs out up there and he says hi, and then he just disappears. All right. This place got bombed. Well, I completely forgot about that. I forget about that every damn time. I just want to get over here, over to the Lambda, so I can climb the roof, get my cache of equipment. Hopefully... You little shit. Forgot about him, too. There we go. Into the water. Glad this isn't, nasty water. Alright, we have 9 out of 49. Let's start taking bets. How many lambdas do you think I'm gonna get by the end of the game? Because I'm definitely gonna miss some. I might just... Ow! I might just, like, completely ignore some. Depending on where it is. I'm actually definitely gonna miss some. But yeah, just start taking guesses on how much, how many of those you think I'm gonna get. What is look out below? Oh, he's giving me shit. Thanks, man. But I do need to come over here. This is another lambda. We can go ahead and take care of this. But we also need to come over here anyway. Okay, why is the lambda... Why am I not getting my lambda progress, huh? But we need to come over here. We need to drop those in the water. This guy needs to not do the thing that he's doing to me right now. Yeah, we need to come down here. And this is our buoy puzzle that I was talking about earlier. Okay, this dude... You need to stop. I would appreciate you not doing these things to me. Your flash is way too damn bright. It's disrespectful. It's irresponsible. And frankly, I am not that big of a fan of it. Hold up. Why is there a lambda there? There's supposed to be materials. Things for me to get. But it just goes up there. Just like, it's a very long-winded route to get up to the same spot. Whatever! I don't care. Splashes in this game are so loud. But it don't matter none, we can go on our pretty little way. And now we have to dodge the helicopter. And by dodge, I mean just hopelessly get shot until we make it to our next destination. Oh, these are drop ships. Get out of my way. Get out of my way! I have things to do, I have goals to accomplish. I'm gonna smear you against the wall and then keep going on my merry little way. That's what I meant to say earlier, my merry little way, not my pretty little way. That's like Pretty Little Liars. No, none of that. Although I'm aware plenty of people like that show. I am not one of them! Let's also try not to get got by man traps. That would suck. Oh, there we go, loading! They're not called man traps, they're called barnacles! I did that in Black Mesa's source as well. I kept calling them man traps when they're called barnacles. Oh, you dude, you're fucked. Good night. Alright. This is where we have to take a little bit of a detour. We need to come up here. And take a little trip in here so we can open up the gate. And I think I have a good opportunity to use a grenade over here. Yeah! And if I remember right, there's a turret section coming up too. Oh, free grenades. That's why I use the grenade, that's right. Yeah. Yeah, there's grenades everywhere, dude. You jerks. Ah! Oh shit, did I just bounce that back to myself with the explosion? I totally did. There was this game that I played so much in, like, early high school. It was called Art of Ascension. It was a Half-Life 2 mod. It was a Half-Life 2 deathmatch mod where... it was basically an RPG. Let's just toss this over here. It was basically an RPG where, as you got kills, you got experience points and you leveled up. Do I do this now or later? I think it's later, on my way back. You leveled up, and as you leveled up, you got skill points that you could spend in various weapons and attributes for, like, speed and shotgun, pistol. I, of course, was the shotgun wielder. I ran around with a shotgun and just blasting people. There was this other dude that was, I guess, I saw him as my rival. Even though he was just way out of my league. But I saw him as my rival because out of our very small community, we were some of the highest level people, and he was the absolute highest level person. And he focused on pistol, and his aim was just absolutely insane. His aim just was ridiculous, and... yeah. But the whole reason that I was reminded of that is because... of the grenades. One of the weapons that you could level up was gravity gun, and the other one was grenade. So you would level up the gravity gun, like, maybe just a tiny bit, and, like, maybe 1 or 2 points into it to give it a little bit of extra launching power. And you would level up your grenades. Actually, I don't even remember if you leveled up the gravity gun at all, but you would level up your grenades to make them do more damage. And... You would do this, like, this neat little trick where you would... I can kind of show you, but I don't have the gravity gun yet. But you could do this neat little trick where you would alternate fire this out, switch to your gravity gun, instantly catch the grenade, like, right out of the air, and then just, like, you would get the timing in your head to cook the grenade. And after a while, you would perfect the timing to where the grenade would just... blow up in their face. It was amazing. It was so much fun. I miss that mod. I told you I was getting nostalgic because of this stupid game. Like, Half-Life 2 was a big part of my high school. I played so many games, so many different mods. I guess it was one of my first real experiences with indie gaming in a way. Because indie games weren't very big back then. What you saw were some very well-produced mods created by independent creators, but you never really saw indie games as much as you do now. But I ended up playing so many mods, way more than I can even pretend to count. And it was a glorious time, it was a great time. To be young again. To be able to have enough time to play every single mod that you ever find on the internet. I wish I had that time, but no, I had to go and get old. Never grow up, kids. Never grow up. Although, if you ever learn how to stop the passage of time and stop growing up, like, you could actually grow up and become filthy rich selling that knowledge. Because people would really like to know how to become, maybe not immortal, but at least, at the very least, they would like to know how to not be ravaged by the effects of aging. You know what I'm saying? Let's take our side path here. Jeez, that was very disorienting. Alright, we get a brief reprieve here under this tunnel. And I think we get a small physics puzzle after this loading zone. We go around the corner and there's going to be like a little bit of a pulley with some boxes that we can create a little makeshift elevator out of. God, these boat driving controls are just so wonky when you're trying to slow down and back up. Okay, this isn't quite the one I had in mind, but I guess I wasn't wrong. Thank you! I needed those. Alright. Please, if I finish this game, and at the end I completely forget to update everybody on what the final lambda count was, let me know. Especially if you guys are actively taking bets. So we need to come around through here. Shoot this lock off. Break in. We got some shit to do. And I mentioned earlier about practicing McCree. Now we totally can practice McCree. Shit. Oh my god. My McCree sucks! Holy shit. That was bad. I shouldn't practice my McCree. That was a bad idea. We'll keep that as our long-range solution, huh? Alright, sound good? Sounds good to me! Baby, don't hurt me no more! Oh, shit. Stop it! Oh my god, did he just fire a manhack? What a dick. Alright, let's get out of here. Where you at? Shit. This is the worst part! Get out of here. Hit! Oh, you dick! How dare you! I'm trying to eat my meal one type of piece at a time, and you are just making it very difficult. Alright, there's one left, I believe. Where? That means there's two left. There we go. I'm so reckless right now. But it's fine. Like, I'm so comfortable with this game. Get him, get him, get him, get him. There we go. Oh, that was a terrible jump. Let's get back up there. Jump across this stupid gap. Jump. Jump around. I can't wait till I get the pulse rifle. That gun is so much fun. Especially once you get the balls. And you can fire them at people and they bounce around and just murder everyone. It's amazing. You gonna help me out here? There we go. Fine. I'll waste ammo. God, the reload is just insane. You know, one of these days I'll start hitting shots more regularly. There we go. Let's also switch back to our submachine gun. Because we're a little bit better with our spray and pray lifestyle. We're not MLG, not yet. Yeah. Leave me alone. Ah! Gotta make it. There we go. Now we can start to have a little bit of revenge. Get out of here with that shit. Get out of here. Leave. 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 We don't want you here. We don't want any. There we go. It's always a good day when you kill that dude. Now we can just jump down to... I guess our boat's over in this direction. We can jump down to our boat. I say that with this, like, a strange kind of accent. Boat. Boat. We can jump down to our boat. We'll jump down to our boat, and then we'll drive away. So let's do it. Onward towards Black Mesa. I mean, we're not quite there yet. We still have at least one rest stop. We have to get through this gauntlet of helicopter death that I absolutely hate. Like, this is the one that I was talking about where we have to worry about the helicopter being an absolute mega dick for absolutely no reason. Like, why does he do this thing? Doesn't he have other better things to do, like go spend time with his family before I kill him? Because we do get to kill him earlier or later, spoilers. And it's a good time. Like, finally getting rid of that helicopter after so long of him just harassing the shit out of us, it's so satisfying. I don't know why I said that like that either. But you know what? You're just gonna have to deal with it. I'm pretty sure it's this way. There's such a large swath of area to the right. Alright, what makes this such a pain in the ass is that you have to dodge these things as you're driving, and you never know, like, exactly where they're gonna land at any given moment. Plus, they also have splash damage, and they're explosive, so they do a ton of damage to you. They also explode if you run over them directly, so you gotta be careful. Just gotta be careful. But at the same time, it's kind of relaxing because I can do whatever I want with my right hand. Like, maybe drink some water. Maybe I can, use the second computer that I have to my right. I don't know why I would have that. But if I did, I would have that option. I could use the second computer that I have on my right and maybe Google about why helicopter pilots are such jerks in Half-Life 2. But yeah, this is just a one-handed experience right now. Wait a minute. I think I saw a lambda. Here we go. Yeah. Get that Lambda Locator achievement going. It kind of takes me out of the exciting music a little bit, but... you know, it is what it is. Okay. Alright, cool. I'm not sure what exactly happened there. I'm kind of glad that I did not end up on top of that, because I don't know what would have happened. Oh, loading screen. The music just cuts out so suddenly. Kind of takes you out of it, you know? I'm not immersed anymore! Oh, now he's shooting at me. Just straight up shooting at me. Up here we go. Ah! Jeez. That hurt a little bit. I'm not gonna lie, I feel a little bit slighted by you, helicopter. Like, you started to shoot me as- oh, God. You started to shoot me as I came out of the tunnel, and then you're just like, you don't care anymore. You don't care about shooting me anymore. You just want to bomb me now. I don't much appreciate that. Mother of God. Ow! I ran directly into that one. It's not good. This is the way. This is the way. I've played Mario Kart more recently than I've played Half-Life 2. So I see these X's when I'm going in this direction, and like my subconscious... my subconscious is saying, hey, you're going the wrong way, you jerk, you dummy. Why don't you go the right way? Why don't you turn around? I really need to find some health. I found some health. I guess I could just go ahead and park this here. I'm not... oh shit. Can you not? Dude, can you not? All I want is to regain my health, regain my armor, and then I'll be out of your hair, okay? That's just all I want from this. You can stop nagging me out there. Here we go. Anything out here for us? Not that I can see. Just get in our boat. Go along our merry way. We don't need to hang out here any longer than necessary. That's not good. Ow! Oh, that didn't feel good. Where am I? What's happening? This is the first time that this has ever happened to me. I think I'm dead. I can't get my boat out of this situation. Help! What have I done? I'm trying to get out. The backup controls are so counterintuitive. I think I'm making it. All right, here we go. Ugh. That sucked. I don't think that's ever fallen on me before. Ow, fuck. All right, I think we're safe. I'm pretty sure this is another loading zone. Yeah. Yeah. That's more like it. Alright, this is the elevator puzzle that I was talking about earlier. So I need to weigh this down. And it will create a ramp for me. Yeah. Just drop some barrels in there. It'll be fine. Maybe a chair. In case somebody wants to have a seat. Let's also find the ladder up to this cache. There's got to be one. Of course there is. Oh, and there's a washing machine or dishwasher, something for us to push over. It's not a cache, it's just... How did they get the freaking dishwasher up here? Or the washing machine, or whatever the hell it is. How did they get that up here? And how is this rickety raggedy piece of shit holding it up? Man, there goes my suspension of disbelief. This game is not good anymore. 0 out of 10. Physics unrealistic. Can't just put a wash. How did it get up there? Look, man. I don't know. I just don't know.
You're Freeman, aren't you?
Yeah.
I wouldn't believe it if I couldn't see with my own eyes. Dr. Gordon Freeman himself.
Yeah. I'm a hero.
Just in time, Doc. We gotta move out before the Combine picks us up. We're just getting ready to pull out.
Better hurry. Gotta tear down this camp and get out of here.
Greetings to the Freeman.
Sup?
Come on in. I'll show you what you're up against.
Alright, well, before you show me what I'm up against, I'm gonna just go on a little bit of a collectathon out here. I think I've already done that. Well, I guess before you show me what I'm up against, I'll end the episode, because we're totally out of time. Just wanted to get through that section and get to this spot. But we're out of time. On the next episode, this dude's gonna have given us a gun. And we're gonna have a gun, and we're gonna go kill that fucking helicopter. We're also gonna go talk to this dude. And I'll see you there!